What's up, everyone? It is May 25th, 2020, Memorial Day. Thank you to all the service women and men that protect this country and everything you guys do, man. I appreciate you guys. Today is exciting because today I will be trying the Murph workout for the first time. So the Murph workout is a workout that they use in CrossFit. It's like a hero workout that they do to remember, you know, heroes. This hero being Lieutenant Michael Murphy, who was killed in action in Afghanistan in 2005. You've probably seen this workout in the CrossFit games. I think they did it in 2015 and 2016. So the workout consists of a 1 mile run, 100 pull-ups, 200 push-ups, and 300 air squats, followed by one more 1 mile run, all wearing a 20 pound weight vest. So there's two different ways you can do it. You can do it unpartitioned, which is you can do the 100 pull-ups first, then the 200 push-ups, and then the 300 air squats all in a row like that. Or you can do it partitioned, which is splitting all the reps up. Some people do like, you know, 10, 20, 30 for so many rounds, or 2, 4, 6 or chippers. They say that the harder way to do it is the unpartitioned way. So that's the way I'm going to do it. Unpartitioned. So I'll be doing the 1 mile run right into 100 pull-ups straight, right into 200 push-ups, right into 300 air squats, and then finishing off with the 1 mile run wearing the 20 pound weight vest. I'm not a CrossFitter. I'm not a military. Just a person who enjoys, you know, pushing himself to his limit. Like I said, I'm in search of my full potential, and I want to push myself as hard as I can. And this workout is said to be one of the hardest workouts. A lot of people say it's the hardest workout they've ever done. So looking forward to getting it done. I've never done it before, so I don't know how I'm going to pace myself. I don't even know what to expect. So we'll see what happens, but I'm excited. We're going to get this done. Those of you at home, you can check this workout out, look it up, do it yourself, see how you do. These workouts are for everybody, you know. Just because, you know, you don't have a weight vest or certain things doesn't mean you can't get it done. There's ways that you can modify it. So do your research, look it up, and do it yourself. Let's get it.
Beginning to Murph, baby.
Woo!
That's good.
Murph.
Yep. 3, 2, 1. Go.
Right, so my mile time was 6 minutes and 40 seconds. Like I said, I've never done this workout before, so I didn't really know how to pace it, and I didn't want to start out too fast and burn myself out. Everybody I've talked to, all the feedback I've gotten said, you know, don't go out too hard out of the gates because you may not finish the workout. And like I said, I've never done it before, so I held back a little bit. I definitely feel like I could have taken maybe 30 to 40 seconds off that first mile, but you know, it's 6:40, still a good time. Right now I'm doing pull-ups. I chose to go with the butterfly technique just because it's the fastest way. I actually just taught myself how to do butterfly pull-ups about 3 weeks ago on a YouTube tutorial video. So that's the technique I decided to go with just because, in my opinion, it's faster than most techniques. I definitely felt every bit of that extra 20 pounds on my body with that weight vest. Definitely started gassing out my arms probably halfway through. But not too bad. Like I said, I paced myself pretty good on that first mile run. By the time I got back in the gym, I wasn't really out of breath or tired. So I was able to get right to work. Didn't really slow down much. I did them in rounds of 10. So I did 10 rounds of 10 reps of the pull-ups. And then halfway through the pull-ups, I actually
ripped my hand. So one of my blisters ripped open, and I had to do maybe like the last 50 with an open wound on my hand. So I switched my my covering over to my pinky so that it would cover that and it wasn't making contact with the bar. So I didn't get any infections or anything. So now we're on push-ups. As you can see, I'm breaking them up into sets of 10. I did that as long as I could. And then when I started getting, you know, a little tired, I went to sets of 5 and then I went down to sets of 2. For the last 100, I was pretty much doing sets of 2 as fast as I could without trying to stop as many times. Yeah, it was definitely tough. The push-ups were definitely the hardest thing for me. I definitely felt it during the workout. That extra 20 pounds pretty much kicked my ass. But I got it done though. Now, as you can see, we are on air squats. And as you can see, I have a wall ball between my legs just to make sure that I'm getting every rep in. Like I said, this is my first attempt at this workout. So I just wanted to make sure that I took my time and felt it. You know, I wanted to feel every rep. I wanted to, you know, I wanted to go into that dark place, man. I wanted to do it the right way. I didn't want to, you know, look back and be like, man, I could have done this or I could have done that. So I made sure that I got every single rep in and made every single rep count, like the way you should. The air squats weren't so bad. I broke them up into sets of 20. So I did 20 at a time until I got to 300. I definitely felt it in my lower back and in my quads. I definitely felt the jelly legs. As I ran that last mile, I was able to finish with an 8:10 mile. Total time was 41 minutes and 49 seconds. I definitely feel like I could have done it faster. And now that I've done it and I've got, you know, some experience with it, I definitely want to do it again and try to do a sub 40.
And that's a wrap, baby.
I will attempt it again in the near future, and definitely every Memorial Day. Thank you guys for watching this video. See you guys again soon.